In this video, I'm going to show you how to personalize ComfyUI templates page. We will do this by adding our own custom category. This will let you display your personal workflows directly in the templates section, providing you with quick and easy access. I made the setup very simple. It's an easy copy and paste solution. Hello everyone, welcome back. If you are new, welcome. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to create your own custom category under the extensions tab. I have an example here. I call it Sherwin workflows. Going inside, I have my workflows. It shows the name, a title, and then a custom thumbnail. Everything you need is available for completely free. There is a GitHub link in the description below. Download the files, and from there, it's a simple matter of copy and pasting. First, make sure your ComfyUI is up to date. Your templates page should look something like this. Notice I have different sections on the left side, including an extensions section at the bottom. If yours does not look like this, your ComfyUI is likely outdated. To update, open your ComfyUI portable folder, go inside update folder and double click on update underscore comfyui.bat. As I mentioned before, there is a link down below in the video description. Click on it, download these two files. Back inside the custom notes folder, we are going to create a new folder. I'm going to name it YouTube tutorial for now. It is best to follow the standard ComfyUI naming convention. Use a word followed by a dash and then another word. Do not use spaces. Open the folder, go inside it. Right now it's blank. We are going to copy the two files from the link. You can press Ctrl C to copy. Inside the tutorial folder, I'm going to right click, paste, or you can do Ctrl V to paste. Next, we need to create a new folder inside. Name this folder Workflows in lowercase. Go inside the folder. This is where you will paste all of your workflow files. Now, obviously, you will need some workflows to make this work. If you don't have your own, you can go to my channel page, click on any video and download any of these workflows. For me, I'm going to use this one animate workflow. I have a video on the channel. Get the JSON file, copy it, and then paste it inside the workflows folder. Okay, we are almost done with the setup. We'll need to get a thumbnail. This image can be anything. It can be a screenshot of your workflow. It can be the output generated by the workflow. It can be something completely unrelated as well. Now, in my case, just for demonstration purposes, I'm going to take a simple screenshot of my screen here. Once you have your image, move it or paste it in the folder. Notice that my image format is currently PNG. During my testing, I found out that PNG files do not work well. I found out that WebP and JPEG format works the best. So we are going to convert from PNG to JPEG. In this particular case, you can also convert from PNG to WebP if you want to. If your image is already in JPEG or WebP, you can skip ahead. If you're on Windows, the process is very easy. Right click on the image, select edit with paint. We don't need to modify the image. Go to file, click on save as, click on JPEG picture. It will ask you for a location. At this point, you should have both the JSON file and the new image file in the folder. I'm going to delete the original PNG. We don't need it. For ComfyUI to detect and match that specific image is for that workflow, you'll need to make sure that the workflow name and the image name are both the same. We'll have to follow that naming convention. For me, I'm just going to go with one-video.json. I'm going to copy the name, paste it for the image. This way, both my image and my workflow have the same name. Okay, time to test out. Let's go inside of ComfyUI. Go to Manager, click on Restart button, confirm. It will say at the top, reconnecting. Wait for it to complete. When you see reconnected message, you can verify by going inside the terminal. Scroll until you see import times for custom node. Look for the folder that you've created. If the folder name appears here, and if it does not show import fail, on the left side, then everything is okay. All right, once you confirm that the folder is showing in your terminal, go back into ComfyUI. We will need to do a hard refresh. A hard refresh simply bypasses the cache of your browser and ensures that all the assets, in our case, it's the workflow and those images, they are loaded properly. I am on Windows. For me, it is pressing and holding Control key plus F5. If you are on Mac, I'm guessing the equivalent is Command plus F5. If it does not work, you can Google it or maybe ask ChatGPT for the equivalent for your specific browser. Now let's go into templates, scroll down on the left side under extensions. If the menu is collapsed like this one, click on the icon to expand it. And all the way at the bottom, I have YouTube-tutorial. This is the folder for my custom node. If you can click on it, if the workflow requires custom nodes or additional models, it will ask you to install these additional custom nodes, just like normal. Okay, so I've only added one workflow here. You can continue the rest of the process, copy all of your workflows into the custom nodes workflows folder, and then you just need to get your associated thumbnail in there. Make sure the name is correct for both the image and the workflow file. Now let's talk about uninstalling the custom node. Normally you would go into the manager, select the custom node and uninstall from there. Because we have our own custom node, we are going to go directly into the ComfyUI custom node folder. Select the folder you want to remove. Simply press delete on your keyboard. Now it's gone. Go back to ComfyUI, click on manager. Click on restart, click on confirm, wait for it to reconnect, go into the terminal under import times for custom nodes. That specific folder name should be gone. For me, the YouTube workflow is no longer showing. Let's go back into ComfyUI. You can close the manager. Once again, we will have to do the hard refresh. Control F5, check your templates page, scroll all the way down on the left side. All right. For me, that YouTube-workflows is no longer there. All right, that's how easy it was to install and uninstall this custom node. For those of you who stayed until the very end, let me show you a bonus project I'm working on. In the templates page here, we can see that ComfyUI has dedicated categories. There is a general type. We have a close source category here. I've created my own called my personal section. Inside it, I have Sherwin's workflow. And this looks similar to what we've done previously, but notice how we have a title, a description, we have tags, and the thumbnail here can have animation. In this specific case, we have one image blending into another. This is great for showcasing the before and after. Now, the main advantage of this version is that we have filters at the top. For example, I can search for new. I get only one result. Remove new, select video. I now have two results. So the filtering works. Right now, the model filtering is not working for me. This is something I'm still working on. This is what I'm working on right now. If I do get this feature working, or at least at a stable stage, I will post an update on my free Patreon page. You can find the Patreon link on the channel page. Click the link, you will see a join free button. Once you join, you will get access to those free posts. I will have a dedicated post, possibly a video explaining how this new version works and how to install it. By the way, if you want to have multiple categories in your extensions section, right now we created one dedicated folder inside of custom nodes folder. You can actually have as many folders as you would like there. You just need to repeat the same process for each of those custom node folders. All right, thank you for watching. As a reminder, all the files are completely free and available using the link in the description below. Let me know if you like this type of content. I didn't go into detail on how to write your own custom node. I actually have a previous video on custom nodes. It was one of my very first video on the channel. That video is a little bit outdated now. I'm not sure how many of you are interested in custom nodes. If you are, Let me know in the comments down below. If we get enough engagement, I will follow up with a dedicated tutorial. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, give it a like. If you have not subscribed, subscribe for more videos. Have a nice day. Take care. I will see you next time.